Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear viewers, today is the first episode of the new series which we are going to start about the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, named Shining Stars. And we have decided to start this series with the 10 blessed companions who are called Ashara Mubashara. These 10 companions were those companions who were given the tidings of Jannah by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, within their earthly life, within their worldly life. They were informed by the Prophet that their Jannah was confirmed. That's why they are called Ashara Mubashara. We do not know about each and every companion from these 10 when they got the tidings of Jannah. But about some of them we know it very well, like Hazrat Usman radiallahu ta'ala and got the tidings of paradise twice from the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. First when he bought the well of Ruma in Medina, and secondly when he gave a huge donation at the time of Tabuk expedition. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said to him that nothing can stop Usman from going to Jannah, his Jannah is confirmed. Similarly, Hazrat Talha radiallahu ta'ala, and when he defended Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in the Battle of Uhud, and he played a very significant role in it, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, then said, Talha, wajabat lakal jannah. Talha, paradise has become wajib for you. But there is a hadith, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, once said, Abu Bakr fil jannah, Umar fil jannah, Usman fil jannah, Ali fil jannah, Talha fil jannah, Zubair fil jannah. He named all the 10 blessed companions and he said that they are the people of paradise. So from these companions, today we are going to discuss the life of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an belonged to the tribe of Banu Taim, which is a branch of Quraysh, and he was known as Abdul Kaaba. The name which was given to him by his parents was Abdul Kaaba, but when Islam came, so Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, changed his name to Abdullah. But the people don't remember him with the name Abdullah. The people usually call him Abu Bakr, and Bakr means a young camel. When Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an was a young boy, he used to spend most of his time with the camels. So looking towards his interest with the camels, the people called him Abu Bakr. That is the style of Arab. Once Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, saw Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, that he was lying on the sand of Masjid Nabawi. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, called him Abu Turab. And once Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, saw a companion, he was having a kitten in his lap. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, called him Abu Huraira. And the people loved Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's name, the Prophet, the name which the Prophet, peace be upon him, gave him. They loved him so much that Abu Huraira said, forget my actual name and call me Abu Huraira, because the Holy Prophet called me Abu Huraira. So everyone knows him with the name of Abu Huraira, and the people don't know that his actual name was Abdul Rahman. So like that, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an was called Abu Bakr. Hazrat Abu Bakr's father was Usman, and he is also famous with his surname Abu Quhafa. And it is something very unique that Abu Bakr was the earliest convert to Islam, but his father Abu Quhafa accepted Islam when the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, conquered Makkah. The people saw that Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an was bringing an old man to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and that old man could not walk properly and he could not see properly due to his old age. He was the father of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an, and then he accepted Islam. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said to Abu Bakr that, Abu Bakr, why didn't you call me to your house? I could come to your house so that Abu Quhafa could accept Islam there. But Hazrat Abu Bakr said, no, Ya Rasulullah, he needs Islam, so he has to come to you. So that's why I have brought him to you. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an had a unique honor that 3 generations of Hazrat Abu Bakr became the companion of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Not only Muslims, but the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. His father Abu Quhafa became a Sahabi. Hazrat Abu Bakr himself was a Sahabi, and his sons became the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So 3 generations became the companions of the Holy Prophet. It is something great for Hazrat Abu Bakr, and none of the other companions got that honor. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an was a childhood friend of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and that's why his characteristics, his qualities were Just like the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's qualities, Hazrat Abu Bakr never did idol worshipping, he never did gambling or drinking or any other activity. He was so good even before the arrival of Islam. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and was one of the few literate people in Makkah. A historian, Belazari, has written that there were only 17 people in Makkah who could read and write when Islam came. When the Prophet announced his prophethood in Makkah, only 17 people were literate and one of them was Hazrat Abu Bakr. And Hazrat Abu Bakr was so wise and intelligent, and he had a great ability to solve the issues and the disputes of the people, that in Makkah, whenever the people had some dispute, they used to appoint Abu Bakr as a judge in their dispute. It's known as arbitration. You know that in Makkah there was not a society, a well-civilized, a well-developed society. There were not courts and things like that. So the people used to appoint someone wise, someone intelligent to solve the issue. And many a time Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was appointed to solve the disputes of the people. And besides that, Hazrat Abu Bakr was financially strong. He had his own business, his own trade. So all these things made Hazrat Abu Bakr a very influential member of Makkah. His tribe was strong. He was literate. He was intelligent. He was wise. And he was so good in his character. So the people loved him and liked him. And when Islam came, the first person with whom the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, shared his experience of revelation was Hazrat Abu Bakr, because he was his closest friend. And Hazrat Abu Bakr became the first free adult man to accept Islam. Outside the family, he was the first person to accept Islam, and he accepted Islam without showing any reluctance or hesitation. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, himself used to say that whenever I invited someone towards Islam, he started arguments with me. And he asked many questions in it. He showed reluctance in it. But Abu Bakr was the only person, when I invited him towards Islam, when I called him towards my prophethood, he believed in me without showing any reluctance, without any question. And the reason behind it was that Hazrat Abu Bakr was so close to the Holy Prophet, he knew him so well that the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, never lied in any issue. So how can it be a lie that he has become a messenger of Allah? And Hazrat Abu Bakr was one of those people in Makkah who were waiting for guidance. They knew that idol worshipping is something wrong. And they were looking for something who could guide them towards the right path. So when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, showed him the right path, invited him towards the deen of Allah, so Abu Bakr immediately followed him and became his supporter. Hazrat Abu Bakr helped a lot Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in converting the other people to Islam. And he became the right hand of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is his great mission. Many of the people in Makkah accepted Islam on Hazrat Abu Bakr's invitation. At least 5 of the 10 blessed companions accepted Islam on Hazrat Abu Bakr's invitation. He convinced him, they were his friends, like Hazrat Usman, Hazrat Talha, Hazrat Zubair, Hazrat Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah, Hazrat Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. Abu Bakr took them to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and they all accepted Islam. Besides that, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and played a very important role in the defense of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in the days of persecutions. It happened many a times in Makkah that Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, started proclaiming Tawheed. Makkans used to consider it the insult of their idols. So when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said loudly, La ilaha illallah, so his enemies used to jump upon him and to hit him. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala used to appear on the scene to defend him. And once they beat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala so much that his face swelled and they pulled out some of his hair, and Hazrat Abu Bakr fainted. But when he recovered, the first question what he asked was that, how is the Prophet? Where is he? The people informed him that he is fine, you are more injured than him. But Abu Bakr had no care about his own self, but he was always worried about the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, safety and his life. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala also spent lots of money in Makkah to buy Muslim slaves and set them free. Like Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala and Hazrat Lubaina and Hazrat Zindra and Hazrat Aflah, who was known as Abu Fukay, many of the slaves were bought by Hazrat Abu Bakr, and he used to set them free. He saved them from the persecutions and he also gave the freedom. His father Abu Quhafa used to ask him that, you buy them to save them from persecutions, that is something understandable. But why do you set them free? You can keep them in your use. You can keep them for your service. But Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala used to say that I buy them for the pleasure of Allah. If I will keep them for my own service, so my reward will be reduced. And Allah appreciated Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala in the Holy Quran for this in Surah Al-Layl. The verses says that وَسَيَجَنُّبَهَا الْأَتْقَى الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَا لَهُ يَتَسَكَّى وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى إِلَّا بِتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى. Allah is praising Hazrat Abu Bakr in these ayat, and Allah says وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى. Allah will give him such a great reward in Akhirah that he will be well pleased. It is also reported that when Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq accepted Islam, he had 40,000 dirhams in his property. But when he was migrating to Medina, he had only 5,000 dirhams left. So he spent around 35,000 dirhams in the cause of Islam, in setting the slaves free and many other causes of Islam. He was so generous, and he never thought second time whenever there was an occasion to spend money in the way of Allah. And one of the greatest things which Hazrat Abu Bakr did in his Meccan life before migration was the confirmation of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's night journey, Al-Isra wa Miraj. When Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, came back from his night journey and he was sharing that experience with the people of Makkah, the people of Makkah were making fun of him and they were not believing in him. Obviously, it was something, it was a great miracle. But Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an was the first person who believed in him without showing any reluctance. Abu Jahl ran to the house of Hazrat Abu Bakr that today even Abu Bakr will be confused. Muhammad has said something big. And he said to Abu Bakr that, Abu Bakr, can you believe a person is claiming that I went from Makkah to Jerusalem and from Jerusalem I was taken to the heavens, I saw heaven and hell, I met Allah, then I came back to Jerusalem, then I came back to Makkah and you people were sleeping. Hazrat Abu Bakr asked him that who is saying all of it? He said, Muhammad is saying all of it, can you believe? Abu Bakr said, so what? If Muhammad is saying, so what is the problem in believing in it? He is a messenger of Allah and all the messengers got miracles. The messenger of Allah tells us that Jibreel is with me right now and he is in Sidratul Muntaha, and now Jibreel is back with this message from God and we believe. So why it is difficult or impossible for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, himself to be in the heavens? Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was so happy with this support of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an that he gave him the title of a Siddiq. Since that day he was called Abu Bakr As-Siddiq, the testifier of truth. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an did a remarkable job at the time of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's migration from Makkah to Medina. All the arrangements were made by Hazrat Abu Bakr. Actually, Hazrat Abu Bakr wanted to migrate much earlier, but Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said to him that Abu Bakr, wait, may Allah will give you a good companion to migrate with. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala understood that the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, wanted him to be with him in the migration journey. So Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala waited for him. Hazrat Abu Bakr arranged the two fast-running camels for migration, one for the Prophet, peace be upon him, one for himself. Hazrat Abu Bakr's daughter, Hazrat Asma radiallahu ta'ala anha, prepared the meal for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Hazrat Abu Bakr hired the guide who had to take them to Medina from an unknown route, whose name was Abdullah bin Urayqid. Abu Bakr hired him. And then Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anha played very, very important thing in the cave of Sora, a remarkable thing which Hazrat Abu Bakr did. When Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and reached the cave with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, named the cave of Sor, Hazrat Abu Bakr entered first and cleaned the entire cave so that nothing will harm the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. He found many holes in the cave and he filled all the holes, but one of the holes was left. So Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and placed his foot on that hole that I will not allow anything to come out from it to hurt the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And then he called the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, inside. And the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, fell asleep. And his head was in the lap of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. And at that moment, something poisonous bit on the foot of Hazrat Abu Bakr. The pain was extreme. The poison was slowing the leg of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an, but even in that extreme pain, he did not even move his leg. Just because if I will move my leg, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, will be disturbed while he is sleeping. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's sleep was more valuable, was more important for him than his own life. That is the thinking of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. That makes him Abu Bakr, and that is the level which no any other believer can achieve, that he could risk his life just for the sake of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's sleep. But the pain was so much that tears couldn't be controlled by Hazrat Abu Bakr, and the tears rolled down from his eyes and they fell on the face of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. The Prophet, peace be upon him, woke up and asked him, Abu Bakr, are you weeping? What happened? Then Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and informed him about the pain, and the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, applied his saliva and the pain vanished. That was something so great. That once Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was sitting with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, under the open sky, and the sky was full of stars. There were countless stars. So Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha asked Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, Ya Rasulullah, is it possible for a person to have so many good deeds like these stars, which are uncountable? So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, as a joke, said to Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Yes Aisha, Umar bin Khattab has done so many good deeds. So Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was shocked, and she was expecting that the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, will name her father Abu Bakr. So when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, saw that Hazrat Aisha got upset on it, so Holy Prophet said, Aisha, what do you think about your father Abu Bakr? Abu Bakr's one night which he spent with me in the cave of Saur, when he did not move his leg, when poison was flowing in his leg, that one single deed is heavier than all these good deeds of Umar. It was such a great night. It was such a great thing which Abu Bakr did. All the companions used to take inspiration from this event of Hazrat Abu Bakr's life. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and in this way accompanied the Holy Prophet until they reached Medina, and in Medina Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and started again service of Islam, showing his generosity. And the first thing what he did in Medina was the purchase of the plot of Masjid Nabawi. That plot where Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, wanted to build the mosque, actually that was the property of two orphans, Sahel and Suhail. They also accepted Islam and they wanted to donate it to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. But Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, did not accept that donation because they were children, they were orphans. Children are not allowed to take such big decisions in their properties. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said someone has to pay the price of this plot. So Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an paid the price. So all the people who are offering prayers in Masjid Nabawi, even today, the reward of their prayers will be going into the account of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an as well, because the first plot was bought by him. And you know, building of mosque is sadqa-e jariya. As long as the people will be praying in that mosque, the reward will be going into the account of Hazrat Abu Bakr in this way. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and got a great honor to become the father-in-law of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, because Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, married Hazrat Aisha, the youngest daughter of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And that was the wish of Hazrat Abu Bakr. He had an old friendship with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, but he wanted to have some family terms with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him as well. And that was the only possible way for that. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, gave a great honor to Hazrat Abu Bakr by making him his father-in-law. There were many other reasons why Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, married Hazrat Aisha. I will discuss it in my another lecture, which will be about Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and remained with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, throughout the struggle of Islam. There was not a single event of his life where Abu Bakr was absent. He was present in all the battles, in all the treaties, in all expeditions he carried out, in all the Umrah journeys, in Hajj. Abu Bakr was always on the side of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And Hazrat Abu Bakr was so wise and intelligent that Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, always consulted him in every important decision. Before decision making, he always consulted two of his most important companions, Abu Bakr and Umar, and he took the benefit of their wisdom and their experience. And many a times Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, followed the ideas of Hazrat Abu Bakr as well. For example, in the Battle of Badr, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked Abu Bakr and Umar what to do with the 70 captives of Badr. It was the idea of Hazrat Abu Bakr that, Ya Rasulullah, they are all our relatives. They were all the relatives of the Meccan people, Muhajireen. And by killing them, we will get no benefit. So it's better to take ransom from them, set them free. May Allah will give them guidance in future and they will become our supporters. Though Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was asking to kill them, but Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is Rahmatul Lil Alameen, is so merciful and kind. He said, Umar, we have already killed 70 people in the battle. If we will kill 70 people who are captives, it will be too much. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, due to his mercy and kindness, decided what Abu Bakr suggested. He took ransom and set them free. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu was so politically wise and genius. The best example of his political wisdom is Treaty of Hudaybiyah. When Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was going to sign the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, all companions wanted not to sign it. They wanted to fight against Quraysh. Because, you know, the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, apparently some of the clauses are biased and the treaty was not looking just. And Hazrat Abu Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was very much against it at that time. But Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the only companion who understood the wisdom underlying the treaty. And he asked Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that, Ya Rasulullah, sign the treaty. In the long run, it will benefit us. And after signing the treaty, when Allah sent down Surah Fatah, and when Allah said, Inna fatahna laka fatham mubeena, then everyone got to know that it was really a victory. Allah called it a victory. And Hazrat Abu Bakr understood it even before signing the treaty. He was so wise. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala set a great example of generosity and service of Islam at the time of Tabuk expedition. At the time of Tabuk expedition, when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked the Sahaba to donate the money for the cause of Jihad, Hazrat Abu Bakr said, it was the first time actually when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked for donations. He never asked his Sahaba to donate anything. It was the first time in Tabuk expedition when Hazrat Abu Bakr said, when Holy Prophet asked for donation. So Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and brought everything he had. Everything he had, his cash and his possessions and all the things in his house, he sold them and gave that money also to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And finally he was rubbing his hand on the wall in his room and there was darkness in the room. So his wife asked, is something left now even on the wall? So he said, yes, I hanged a needle on it. I wanted to get that needle also. Prophet Muhammad is asking for donation. So Abu Bakr does not want to have even a single thing left in his house. That was the passion of Hazrat Abu Bakr. That was Hazrat Abu Bakr's services for Islam, that he was ready to sacrifice everything for it. In 9th year after Hijrah, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, made Hazrat Abu Bakr Amirul Hajj. He led the Hajj and he delivered the khutbah in Arafat. And in 10-8, when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, performed Hajj, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an was there with him. And when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, fell sick, Hazrat Abu Bakr was appointed as the Imam by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And Hazrat Abu Bakr led 17 prayers during the sickness of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And in those days, Hazrat Abu Bakr in some of the prayer was late and Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala and was going to lead the prayer. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, no, as long as Abu Bakr is there, no one will lead Muslims but Abu Bakr. And in this way, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, gave a hint that in the absence of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, Abu Bakr is the best. When Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, passed away, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an delivered an official speech in Masjid al-Nabvi. Though he was the closest friend, he was also shocked, but he controlled himself and he consoled all the companions and he recited a very relevant verse of the Holy Quran in front of the companions. وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Muhammad was none but a messenger of Allah, and many messengers came and they passed away. And he announced that if someone worships Muhammad, so Muhammad has passed away. But if someone worships Allah, so Allah is ever living. And there was a question that where should we bury the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him? Hazrat Abu Bakr answered it and he said, I have heard it from the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that where a prophet dies in the same place, he should be buried. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was buried in the same room where he passed away, and that was the room of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and after that Hazrat Abu Bakr was elected as the Caliph. And his services as the Caliph will be discussed in some other lecture. Wa akhru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.